Hello everybody, my name is Tadey and welcome to my channel. How are you doing on such a beautiful day? I hope you're doing very, very fine. Well, today I have something special for you. It's not gonna be a vlog, it's gonna be a tutorial about how to make a video about... Oh. Hey man, what I'm doing here, I'm working, can't you see this?
Sorry, just need to put these boxes somewhere.
What boxes? I don't care about any boxes, yeah. Come on. What, does this room like looks like a warehouse to you or what?
Yeah, I'll put them there, right?
Okay. No, just put the boxes down here. And just leave the room. Don't go there because you're gonna ruin my setup of lights and all that stuff. Just leave the boxes here and just...
That's fine.
Leave the room out, please. Jesus. Yeah. You know that I can still... hear you and see you in the screen of the camera above there. Yeah. I hope you enjoyed that intro that you have seen. Today I'm not gonna vlog, I'm gonna make another tutorial. It's been a long time I haven't made any tips and tricks about how to create videos. This is going to be a very, very unordinary tutorial about how to clone yourself, but not in a way that you will be walking around. I know that this could be very useful, but anyway, it's gonna be how to clone yourself in a video. First of all, you have to record yourself twice, you know, first the one side and then the second one the other side, you know, the other you. Whatever that means. So you have two shots of you in different positions and make sure that there is enough space between each of you so that you're not very, very close to each other, to yourself. Damn, that sounds weird. Make sure that you're not too close to yourself so it's enough of space between you so that there won't be any unnatural interference, you know, some ghosts or something like that. So if you're actually interacting with yourself, it's good that you have some kind of a script in your head in advance so that you know when to be silenced and when to talk so that you don't get a footage when two guys that are you actually are talking all over each other. So yeah, that's probably it. So I will be heading to Adobe Premiere now to show you what exactly you have to do when you have two footages of yourself interacting with each other. If you're shooting with a camera and you are using external mic and not directly connected to a camera, you will probably need to merge those files. You know, you will probably need to put an audio from your microphone, from your external microphone, under the video that you're actually filming with a camera. It's amazing tool that is in the Adobe Premiere. It's called Merge Tool. Who would have thought that, right? You can do this like this and it's not a problem at all. So I will show you this now before we can start actually masking ourselves out. So let me just jump into that video in Adobe Premiere. Let me just jump here. Whoa! Yeah, not good. So now you see this is the footage of me on the left side and this is the audio of the footage. I've actually put them aside, you know, I put this video like this. It was like this before. So I put this video up and this audio down. It's much easier to have like this because you will then know which audio is from which file. If you need to move anything left or right to arrange this, you know. And now I will put the second file, that's the second me, in this video here. Let me just... No, I didn't want to do that. Let me just zoom in so I'll know where the start is. You would probably have to listen a couple of times to catch the real pace of a talk, of the act, so you will have the right conversation flow between those two footages. So let's go. Here we are now in Adobe Premiere in our project here. Let me just show you what you can hear now if you are just playing this. Let's see, this is the intro that I'm talking in on the left side, and here is something going on the right side, some noise. Let's just see. Yeah, I've opened there. You cannot see anything, right? You don't see anything here. Let me just... Yeah, you see, I'm talking to a wall. I recommend you to go to the scene where both of you, of the objects, or both of the actors, you know, both of you are in the scene, are in the scene. So you need to select the top layer and then go to the effect control here up and the left. Of course, I'm in editing mode now. And here you have the opacity. So you will just bring the opacity down a little bit so that you can see the other yourself. That's kind of, that really is a weird thing to say. So you will see the other yourself in the video, in the preview video. So this looks like this. Like that, I see.
Looks like a warehouse to you or what?
I'll put them there, right? Okay, no.
Just put the box.
Whoa, come on.
Just leave the room.
Okay, that's enough. You see what's the main idea here, right? So that you're actually having a conversation with yourself. What's the next thing you have to do? If you were shooting on external microphone, as I've said it before, you will need to make sure that... I'll just zoom this out. You will need to make sure, okay, I've done this for this footage here, you know, for the first footage I've done this already, and the second footage I haven't merged the file. So what you need to do is just select the audio file you have from the second footage, and then the video file, and just press Ctrl and select the second footage, video footage, then right click on any of those files you have selected and click on merge clips. You have here merge clips. I love to say merge. Anyway, merge clips. And then you have this little window here and you select the audio. I have selected already. Just like the Adobe knows what I want, okay? So select audio and just use this track channel 1. And you press OK, and then the magic happens. It's like... You see there, now you have a new file. It's called Merge. Adobe will find out where the sound is actually the same from the external, from the audio file, and from the video. Okay, now I put those two files together now, and I just need to delete the file that's with bad audio. So now you can see that both files are inserted in the video. Now what we have to do is to make a opacity away, and this opacity needs to be, you know, 100% on both files, on both footages, and then you have to mask yourself out. So I will mask myself out from the upper footage. Let me just show you in this Adobe here, my friend Adobe. Come on, let's go, and you will see. I have a really, really easy thing to do now, because let me just unopacity this. Unopacity, is that a word? I'm not sure. Let me just put this 100. So now you will see only the upper footage and not the second one. So what I need is to make sure that I'm on the first frame here. I'll just look so, and where I have this little free draw Bezier, and Bezier, I'm not sure if that's French or something. I just click on it. I will just do this. Let me just go to, no, 50%, 25%, so I'll have much more space around the window. So free draw Bezier, I will just, because I have this line here, you see this line of a wall when the wall ends? I love this line because I can now separate these two footages by this wall. Make a straight line down there, select myself in or out, and voila! I'm there. We're both there. Me and me are there. This is how it looks like. Very, very easy to make, to create. And okay, let's just see how this is working now.
It's gonna be a tutorial about how to make a video about... Oh. Hey man, what I'm doing here, I'm working.
Anyway, let's... You can see how easy is this to make a clone yourself in the video. So you can just play around with different kind of sets and different kind of scenarios and footages as you want. And yes, what I need to do next is I just need to make sure that everything is at the end as it should be. So when I leave out, okay, now that's not good, that's not good. Okay, let me just see where this ends. Yeah, it's somewhere like this. And I just cut this all till this point. I will just use snap tool so I won't have it. Hard work and just use V. So easy, so easy. Yeah, about this, I just snapped this out. Very, very easy. That's like taking candy from a baby. And that's it. I have a perfect set. So what I'm gonna do now is I'll use Lumetri Color. That's the perfect effect for coloring the videos. And Lumetri Color, it's perfect. So I will use this. I won't use it on each footage separately, but I will use it as an adjustment layer. So what I need to make sure is that I have here in my project interaction window adjustment layer. So I click on the right click on the mouse and new item, and we have here adjustment layer. Click adjustment layer, click OK, and here it is, adjustment layer. I just put this adjustment layer here. Of course I need to stretch it out. Let me just go here to effect and just find Lumetri Color and just drag to adjustment layer. And what I need to do is be creative. Here is Lumetri Color in the effect control window, creative, and here I can just use any of these presets. I somehow like this SLB HDR or something. You see, it's much more dramatic. Anyway, whatever, you can use anything you like. Maybe this one, it's much more brighter. Minus blue, I'm not sure, it's so big. You can use monochrome if you want. You can use Kojak, but that's not bad, right? So let me just see how this looks. I will probably just decrease this intensity of the Lumetri Color effect. So I'll put it like somewhere like 30. Let's put it on 37, right? 37 is a great number, right? And of course I will just do some curves here. I'll just pop out whites, some more brightness, and just leave the dark into the room. Maybe too far. Okay, something like that. Maybe that's looking quite good. And all you have to do is now just put this little fella in the rendering machine. So file, export here, medium, and here's a beautiful window. And you just name it like you want. And if you're going to use it on YouTube, just use here YouTube as you wish. I have this high bitrate match source because I've made myself some kind of preset here. I'm usually using 2-pass, but it's not so necessary if you're just using this for YouTube videos. So anyway, you just need to do this and then hit Q, and then you're in the crazy window of rendering, right? That's it for now. I hope I somehow helped you with this kind of a tutorial. I will definitely record and film more of tutorials like this and like any others. And probably I will do this regular, weekly, probably. I will just do my best to do it like that, you know. Anyway, thanks for watching now, and have a great day, have a great weekend. Be cool, stay awesome. If you like this video, I hope you will hit the thumbs up button, and I hope you will also subscribe if you haven't already. And yeah, what else can I say? Take care, be good, stay awesome, and see you in the next video, in the next tutorial vlog, maybe something like that. I'm not quite sure what else, whatever will be. Something will definitely be. Okay then, see you in the next video and stay awesome. Bye.